In 2006, this man, Dr. Aly Barakat, an Egyptian geologist, traveled to Visoko, in Bosnia. The aim was to study the pyramid-shaped hills and determine if they were natural or man-made. He spent 42 days exploring them in detail, and it's still not clear today if he was sent by Dr. Zahi Hawas himself or if he decided to go there at his own risk. But risk? What risk, you might be wondering? Well, let's hear what the leader of the supposed discovery, Dr. Osmanagich, has to say about it, and I'll give my opinion on the matter, as well as the whole pyramid controversy in the area. Welcome to Ancient Puzzles.
Okie dokie!
This was the conclusion of Dr. Aly Barakat regarding the so-called Bosnian Pyramid of the Sun, before leaving Visoko. He also published a report sometime after his visit to the site. But let's see first what happened when he got back to Cairo. Dr. Osmanagich explains.
Dr. Aly Barakat went back to Cairo. He was working for the government ministry. And he got fired.
Shame on you!
They said, you betrayed our country.
What?
By confirming that bigger and older pyramids exist.
Really, nigga?
How does he know that? Was he there?
After the meeting, Zahi Hawas is coming in front of the reporters saying, there are no pyramids in Bosnia. Those so-called concrete blocks are not concrete, they are natural. Aly Barakat is no expert in pyramids. And Osmanagich is hallucinating.
Quite often, I would say.
They fired him. What did we do? Well, we kept hallucinating. And opened the project for volunteers from all over the world. And they came at their own expense.
Okay,
hundreds
stop.
Of them.
He is a happy man, so Dr. Aly Barakat sacrificed his job and maybe his career for the Bosnian pyramids, and to honor him, the best he could do was, okay, let's keep hallucinating, let's keep digging, and let's do it for free. Goodbye, Dr. Barakat, see you later, or not. Seems like Dr. Osmanagich always has someone to do the dirty work for him, call it confirming the pyramids that no one wants to confirm, or spending the whole day removing the soil and clearing the tunnels. Yep, very nice. To be fair, he claims at least to have donated a lot of money to the Bosnian Pyramid of the Sun Foundation, basically created and directed by him. So, who knows? Seems like he's been a pretty successful businessman for more than 25 years, so I'm going to believe it's true. Now that we know that he doesn't want to hire Dr. Barakat, and that volunteers are the main pillar of this project, there's an obvious problem here. Assuming we're dealing with an artificial structure, or that there are man-made objects below the ground, it's important to have qualified people excavating, and that's pretty much impossible to obtain, recruiting volunteers only. This is not something everyone can do. Keep in mind, archaeological methods are taught at university, and must be for a reason. If I, for example, do it without the appropriate knowledge, maybe I mess up and damage something, or I'm not able to identify relevant pieces, or whatever. Dr. Osmanagich would probably say that all the academic world is against him, and no one is sending archaeologists to Visoko. Well, maybe there are good reasons to not send qualified professionals, and has nothing to do with a plan to hide the truth. On the other hand, if there are no pyramids, a natural landscape is being destroyed. From that point of view, it is not difficult to understand that the European Association of Archaeologists condemned the Bosnian pyramids as a cruel hoax. Now, before jumping into Dr. Barakat's observations, there is something about his visit that really puzzles me. Dr. Zahi Hawas never admitted to send him to examine the site, so officially it was his decision. I understand that Barakat is a geologist and Hawas an archaeologist, but how is it possible to spend 42 days out of your country when you have a job? The only way it makes sense is when that's precisely part of your job. I could not find what Dr. Barakat has to say about it, but looks to me someone told him to go there and debunk the pyramids, since that's exactly what a geologist can do. If these are natural hills and not pyramids, a geologist should be able to tell the difference. And obviously something didn't go as planned. Again, we don't know for sure who sent him, but Hawas back in 2006 was a very powerful man, just saying. Dr. Osmanagich seems to know even the conversation they were having right before the dismissal. But yes, there were consequences for Dr. Aly Barakat after this mission. Let's discuss now his geological observations. Dr. Aly Barakat.
Can nature made separate them? Right. Okay, yes. It can separate them, but still it is angular.
Yes, angular.
Because there is no movement.
No movement
to make this
right.
Slab.
No movement.
Just if I just crack the crack, it must be zigzag. So I think it is man-made these right. Faces.
Okay, he's showing here one block of the supposed pyramid of the sun that could be man-made. Basically, the sides of the block are suspicious. Even assuming he's right, we don't find them everywhere. Do you think these are rectangular blocks, for example? No. This conglomerate material, by the way, is artificial concrete according to Dr. Osmanagich, but he never shows the lab reports where he sent the samples. His presentation, more or less the same every time, shows information, but I don't think it's the official report. On the other hand, Osmanagich claims the civilization who constructed the Bosnian Pyramids started digging the tunnels below first, and the material extracted was recycled to make the concrete blocks. There's more to say about these tunnels, but let's first finish with Dr. Barakat's claims. I found a personal blog, linked in the video description, where it's possible to download the full report and also read mails Dr. Barakat sent to the owner of the blog. Does he still say it's 100% pyramid in the report? Well, the conclusions say the pyramids are natural hills, modified in some places by human activities. There's compelling evidence, according to him, that the pyramid shape and north-south-east-west orientations were deliberate, but the results are still inconclusive and require further detailed geological, geophysical, tectonic, and archaeological studies. To summarize, he is suggesting that the natural hills were mostly sculpted in the shape of a pyramid, hence admitting in the report that these are not pyramids, but very big sculptures instead. Covering stones were used, he says, to adjust the imperfection of the original mass, explaining, for example, why rectangular blocks are not present in many places. Anyways, it looks to me he realized he was very wrong at first, or maybe he was afraid of suffering more consequences, or both, but he probably tried to slightly clean up the mess with this report. It is true that natural features are part of some of the well-known pyramids, but when someone says human hands sculpted the body of the pyramid from top to bottom, it is pretty clear that it's not a pyramid. I personally don't think these are pyramids at all, and pictures from other angles do not show the pyramid shape. Aly Barakat noticed the deformation of the hills, which he attributes to natural processes, plants, and human activities. He thinks, by the way, tectonic movements had the most significant impact. Well, I guess millions of years ago, the hills looked very different, so the argument could be that this happened to a natural hill, and not to something man-made. Overall, the hill shape to become pyramids, as a theory, is not very convincing. In the best case scenario, there are maybe some artificial blocks in the so-called Pyramid of the Moon. I don't think that's impossible, but again, if finally proven, that's not enough to confirm it's a pyramid. It's important to keep in mind also that the work of nature shouldn't be underestimated, and that includes the orientation of those hills, since yes, it could be just a coincidence. And let's not forget about two anomalies Dr. Osmanagich presents. First one is a 28 kHz frequency, he claims, electrical engineers, sound engineers, and other experts measuring electromagnetic fields detected on top of the Pyramid of the Sun. The signal was recorded, but it is not something we can hear, so they converted it to 8 kHz. And this is how it sounds. Osmanagich says it's an energy beam that wouldn't be there if this wasn't a pyramid. If this is not a lie they created, which is a possibility to be honest, it's quite interesting, but it doesn't prove it's caused by something artificial. Honestly, I don't see why this can't happen in other places of our planet, even if he claims Mother Nature doesn't do that. Astronomers, for example, have been studying radio signals coming from distant stars, and the main hypothesis is that these are generated by stars and not civilizations, so why not? If true though, I would say this requires further investigation. The following, though, makes the former quite difficult to believe. The Rabne tunnels, or healing tunnels, as Osmanagich calls them. This is the most pseudo-scientific part of this puzzle. There's no proof that material from there was used to create artificial concrete blocks, and there are good reasons to think these are not prehistoric tunnels, but modern tunnels instead. Dr. Osmanagich has been accused of digging the tunnels himself, and his argument is that the tunnels were sealed for unknown reasons during the Neolithic using filling material from the surrounding area. So he claims the volunteers are clearing the tunnels, not digging them. That is weird, to say the least, but the show doesn't stop here. He also claims that the tunnels have healing properties due to high proportion of negative ions inside. How scientific is that? I don't know, but this is a very important element he uses to bring people to the site. In the presentation, he shows something that apparently repairs the aura, energy, or whatever. It's a mystery what kind of technology they're using, cause he doesn't explain, but he's very proud of the healing tunnels. And well, I really hope people going there to visit Dr. Osmanagich never stop visiting a real doctor. Last but not least, academics are not the only ones who don't buy the Bosnian pyramids. The vast majority of alternative researchers don't believe it as well, although I have to say Osmanagich is very honest about it, basically trying to make fun of them all the time. And well, at the end of the day, whether people like it or not, he's winning this war. All the attempts to stop the project have failed, and Osmanagich even went to court when he wasn't allowed to dig for 5 years. The hills became protected areas, and in the so-called Bosnian Pyramid of the Sun, there's an old fortress 100% restricted. Anyways, the verdict said that, with permission, you can still dig out of the fortress zone. And I don't know the arguments he brought to get permission, but that was the final result, upsetting academia and everyone against the project. For Bosnia, this has been positive for tourism, so I guess that's an important factor to understand how is it possible Osmanagich achieved all of this, mocking all the detractors throughout the years. He created the ultimate hoax. A cruel, money-grabbing, and at the same time, funny, hoax. It's impossible to go any further than that. Alright, that's all. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, drop a thumbs up, comment, and don't forget to subscribe. It's free, and you don't have to dig. New content will be uploaded as soon as possible. See you next time. Bye.